Peace and blessings, everyone. This is Queen Ifama. I am the Truth Terrorist. Welcome to my channel. I know I haven't been doing any videos lately. It's because I haven't had much to say about a lot of things. I think that I've listened to other people's videos. They've said, you know, what I would say. So I'm like, why would I reiterate it? I really don't have no additional thought outside of what I've read about various subjects. But what I wanted to inform you today is that I'm taking my channel in another direction. It's going to focus a lot on my jewelry creations, how I create the jewelry, and in that aspect, it's going to be my creating jewelry while I'm talking to you about something. It may not be about jewelry, but it is whatever I'm going to talk about, that's what's going to inspire that piece, okay? Because I think that symbols are very important and have always been important in the history of mankind. And that is why I use various symbols and shapes in my jewelry, is because I'm trying to relay a message. You know, a message that comes to me through my spirit. And, you know, this is how, you know, I express my thoughts and my feelings. And I do that through my jewelry. So hopefully you will come to my website, which is www.earthandoceanjewelrydesigns.com, or you can visit my Etsy shop at www.etsy.com/shop/earthandoceanjewelry. Okay. And I also have a Facebook page. I also have a Facebook fan page. I also have a group on Facebook for Earth and Ocean Jewelry Designs. So I will be putting that information down in my description area so that you won't have no excuse saying, and that's dye on my finger, people, from when I've been dyeing some leather. So, you know, don't get it misconstrued that this is dirt, because it's not. It's dye, because I am dyeing raw leather now. You know, I've been doing it, but I kind of got away from it and got really, my spirit was moving me more toward the clay, like this piece is made out of polymer clay. But now I'm trying to, you know, I'm getting back, my spirit is moving me back toward leather. So guess what? Leather and polymer clay will get married, honey. That's what's getting ready to happen at Earth and Ocean Jewelry Designs. And I want you to be a part of it. So, you know, check me out. Support me. When you like my things on Facebook, share them with your friends. Share them with your public feeds. I really appreciate it, because people, that is how it's done. I know a lot of times we see something and we just like it, you know, because we like it. But, you know, in order to help the artist, you share it. You know, you share your like, even if you're not going to buy it, you share it amongst your friends and family. And perhaps one of those people may like to purchase it for themselves. Or they see you like it and might purchase it for you. That's the whole idea. So anyway, with that said, that is the direction that I'm going in. This is one of those rings I just made. Do you like this? This is my little snake ring. I don't know if y'all really looked up the symbolism behind the snake. It's very interesting. I also got a suggestion from someone to make them a shark necklace right now. I had never even thought about sharks. You know what I'm saying? That goes to show you there's so many symbols that represent some kind of thought or feeling or idea or something. And so when I begin to research, because I don't make nothing unless I know what I'm making, okay? So I researched the shark. Lo and behold, the shark is a very interesting totem. So I think, you know, I looked at it and I said, hey, this is worthy of me. Well, the person I made it for, I didn't make it to their specific specifications, but, you know, I showed them the completed project. They weren't pleased with that. They wanted me to do something else with it. Hey, once I'm done with it, I'm done with it. I'm not going back, add nothing or taking away nothing. That's just how I do. I put it out there for someone else, or I keep it for myself, which I think this particular piece, I'm going to keep for myself, because I really, really like it. And I like the symbolism behind it. So I think I'm going to keep this piece, and maybe I'll make another one. I'm going to tell you, making that shark from your, with your hand out of clay, You know, it ain't like I got a mold to do it with. You know, I had to actually look at a picture of a shark and actually create that. But as I was doing it, I was thinking about the symbolism of the shark. So, you know, that idea is what helped me create the piece that I made. It's a necklace and earring set. And I will, you know, I got some pictures on my Facebook page that I'm going to post with me wearing it, because I think I'm going to keep that for myself. But I'm inspired, you know, by other people. And so even though this person did not like what I created for them, it doesn't deter me, because I like it. I like the final output. So, you know, with that said, I'm going to come out. I'm looking for other symbolisms. I know butterflies. I mean, it's just so many things that, so many symbols that, that we as human beings have attached meaning behind to remind us of the principles. You know, remind us of principles that we have committed to or say that we want to do in our lives. These symbols remind me. I just don't wear ox for the hell of it. I just don't wear kyra shells for the heck of it. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I just don't do mud cloth and things like that just for the sheer design of it. There's a method and a meaning behind each piece that I make. So anyway, with that said, I hope to see you soon. I'm putting everything down in the description box so that you won't have no excuse. You won't have no excuse whatsoever to support me, spread me around like marmalade on a piece of toast. You are welcome to do that. So with that said, this is Queen Ifama. I am the truth terrorist and the designer of earth and ocean jewelry designs. Peace, everyone.